Time for another bite-sized chunk of information about LFR bosses and how to tank them, in this particular case as a guardian druid. Today we're talking about the second boss of the third wing of LFR called Sludgefist. It's the one that you fight straight after Shriekwing. If you haven't seen Shriekwing video and you would like to know everything about the bosses, they're all available to you in the playlist and on my channel. Today, let's talk about Sludgefist. Oh, Sludgefist is an awesome boss. Really love it as a tank, even though I wiped more than once with my LFR group and had to rejoin another LFR group because too many people have left. Anyway, Sludgefist is a fun disaster. Even though mechanics are very basic, but people in LFR cannot get even basic mechanics, and I don't think it would surprise any of you who have been playing World of Warcraft for a while and have been in LFR at least once. Okay, Sludgefist. The fight with Sludgefist happens exactly in the same room where you fought Shriekwing, okay? And I assume that you have been through Shriekwing before coming here. Not that there is too much information specific to this fight, but the surroundings environment you would be familiar from the Shriekwing fight. As I said in the previous video of this bite-sized chunk advices from me, if you don't have DBM, deadly boss mods, do not rob yourself from a much easier experience, especially as a casual tank. Go to Curseforge, spend 2 minutes of your time, install the add-on and thank me later and enjoy life as a tank in Shadowlands. Sludgefist is an awesome dude, I really like him. What needs to happen is you have those four pillars in the middle of the room. As tanks, you need to engage him at first in the far corner or against the far wall of that hall. Yeah, you need to tank him further away from the pillars, but not too far away. Hear me out. He casts Stomp. You need to run out of the Stomp as everyone because too much AoE damage, otherwise you don't want to take that AoE damage. Most importantly for you as a tank, and that only you can see visually once you start tanking there, you need to basically measure distance yourself there when you are in the surroundings of Sludgefist. You need to tank him in such a way that you are not too far from the pillars, but at the same time that his Stomp AoE circle does not reach any of the pillars. It's critical. If Stomp reaches pillars, it ruins the pillars, it crashes the pillars. That prevents you from executing second very critical piece of mechanic there in Sludgefist fight. When his attention is on one of the tanks, he will periodically put a red big arrow above the head of the other tank. That other tank needs to not sleep and pay attention and look at DBM add-on notifications on the screen, as well as just pay attention. And as soon as that arrow pops, he has fairly limited amount of time to charge to one of the pillars, to the closest one, closest pillar, and hide behind it. Because Sludgefist is about to run like a huge dude towards that other tank and smash into the pillar or whatever is in his way. And that is important. If he smashes into pillar, he breaks the pillar and he's stunned for a bit. And people pile onto him, he takes extra damage, I believe, correct me if I'm wrong. And that's where the main chunk of DPS happens on him. If the other tank failed to recognize this moment and failed to run to the pillar, basically, if Sludgefist runs to the tank, I cannot guarantee that he will kill the other tank instantly, maybe not, but most importantly, he will just knock the other tank down and keep running until he hits a wall. If Sludgefist hits a wall once, he basically ruins the whole building, like the rubble starts falling from the sky, there is just too much AoE on the whole raid, it's a wipe. So it's critical. There are two mechanics in this fight, but it's so hard to execute them properly in LFR, especially when you need to coordinate and understand each other with the other tank. There is a bit of distance measurement. You don't want his Stomp to destroy any of the pillars because you need all four of them. With the average DPS that an average LFR raid is pumping out, you will need the time that's required for you to DPS him with the help of those four pillars. So basically, in other words, Sludgefist will have time to charge at the other tank four times. So you need four pillars to protect yourself as a tank, as the other tank, and let him slam his head into the pillar, break the pillar then obviously, and be stunned for quite some time, and let your friends pile on and DPS him. Does it make sense? We had hilarious wipes, frustrating wipes, hilarious conversation happening in the chat, but that's basically how Sludgefist fight goes. As long as you, as a tank especially, you pay attention not standing in AoE, in the rumbling AoE. You pay attention on your defensives, he hits hard, he hits like a truck, he looks like a truck, and he hits like a truck, okay? Make sure his stomp AoE does not reach any of the pillars. That's critical. It's absolutely critical. And as soon as the arrow is above your head, or for the other tank, as soon as the arrow is above their head, they need to turn around, drop whatever they're doing, and run to the pillar and hide behind it, letting Sludgefist charge to the pillar, break the pillar, smash his nose a little bit about it, against it, and that is exactly how you're going to defeat Sludgefist. Fun boss, really enjoyed it. Hopefully this very, very quick, casual, friendly guide, mini guide, was helpful for you. If it was, please like the video, please subscribe to the channel. More of these bite-sized chunk information kind of advice things. I'm experimenting with this format, as I said to you. If you have not yet cast your vote, please let me know in the comments down below if you're enjoying this, if it's better than a long 15-minute ramble on a fairly basic topic. So in this particular case, I hope it's helpful. At the same time, we stay connected, you and I. And hopefully you've subscribed for more. That definitely tells me that you're motivated and motivates me to produce more better content for you, my friend. Thanks very much. I'll be speaking with you next time. I think about the third boss of LFR, unless something else comes in between. We have some announcements from Ian. I'm waiting for some news about next patch coming out, whatever, you know, we will be talking about that kind of stuff. But next time we'll talk about the Stone Generals, that fight. Ooh, that fight, oh my god. But we will wait, we will wait. Just wait, I'll see you next time. We will speak about it then. See you later, bye bye.